Praise to the Almighty God for His blessing and grace we can gather here to attend the ACNS meeting online, yeah, because of this pandemic COVID-19 event. Yeah. So special thanks to the President of Neurosurgery Society, Professor Abdul Hafid Bajamal, and also the Chairman of this committee. And I would like to welcoming all the participants. Hopefully you are all in a good shape, keep healthy with your family, and prepare to attend the scientific discussion meeting, etc., until the end of the Congress closed by the chairman of the committee. I would like to present online. We are sorry that we cannot meet offline or meet each other like before. The title today is the unilateral pedicular screw fixation as a minimally invasive surgical procedure with equal outcome compared to bilateral. It is a case series and a literature review. So for the introduction, the pedicle screw is necessary to stabilize the spine that we consider unstable after, especially for decompression procedure. Usually, we use bilateral screw fixation. It can provide a rigid fixation and accelerate also the side effect adjacent segment disease degeneration, and also may increase the osteoporotic related implant device. That one or two side effect of the bilateral fixation, but we need to stabilize the segment if we consider it unstable. How about the unilateral pedicle screw? It was presented before by the Dr. Pelu with a meta-analysis for the lumbar degenerative disease. And the result of the systematic review that having a shorter operative time, of course, we do the half work there, and less blood loss, of course, it's obvious we expose only half of the common exposure, and of course lowering the hospital cost. Based on that, we consider this kind of procedure as relatively less invasive, and hopefully having similar clinical outcome and radiological outcome. So based on that, we based on this kind of research question, we conduct a few cases treated by unilateral stabilization, not only in the lumbar, also in the cervical and thoracic area. Five patients were included in two institutions, because I give service in two institutions as a neurospine surgeon. All operation was done by the same surgeon, and hemilaminectomy stabilization procedure were done, and a post-operative clinical and also radiological were evaluated. Of course, the surgical method incision was planned with the aid of C-arm using midline linear incision, proceed by subperiosteal dissection of the muscle ipsilaterally, concordant with the symptomatic site, without exposing the contralateral site. So make the work faster, less bleeding, and less screws or instrument is implanted. Screw insertion and rod placement as usual. The difference only, it's only ipsilateral site. The needs of facetectomy or hemilaminectomy to decompress nerve roots is considered to be done as usual without any different. The difference only unilateral. This the patient you can see on L1 and 2 screws unilaterally. Patient was came with the disc herniation with progressive radicular pain on the left leg with a weakness 2 of 5 motoric score. And we did hemilaminectomy, unilateral screw fixation, and decompression were appropriately done. And 2 weeks postoperatively, patient had significant improvement of his strength and the pain was alleviated. The next patient on the cervical area, you can see on C5 until C7, the patient was came with unilateral complaining pain on the her left hand and also weakness. After decompression unilaterally, all nerve root can be decompressed properly. Postoperative, she completely relief from her pain with motoric strength score 5 of 5. The third case, we did the hemilaminectomy on L2 until L4 because of a left side ischialgia due to disc herniation on the level L2 L4. The needs of decompression, foraminotomy, medial fasciectomy, discectomy was done as usual. So the different only unilateral, so we consider less invasive. The next case, 56 years old, unfortunate man with the symptom of weakness of his extensor hallucis longus muscle associated with right side foraminal stenosis, and we did hemilaminectomy and unilateral screw fixation was done. So this highlight of this report was not how we do the decompression. I believe it's already known by all the spine surgeon, but how we do less invasively using unilateral approach and unilateral fixation. So the highlight was a outcome by 5 patients was the same as a bilaterally exposure patient. The last patient, L45S1, we did unilaterally using a macrolumbar spreader, and the patient also relieved from the pain with a good motoric improvement. The discussion. Pedicle screw and rod placement is essential to achieve stable fixation in treating the surgically back pain or spine pain patient, but it provokes a pre-exiting instability. So, using open posterior approach such as decompressive laminectomy fusion disrupts the natural anatomy and posterior ligament complex. So the surgery itself contribute to progression of adjacent segment disease. This report from Dr. Tai Hwan Kim. Unilateral fixation is sufficient to maintain stability for 1 or 2 segment fusion. In the laboratory study by Dr. Yuichi Kasai, in Mie University, Japan, the report mentioned in LLIF procedure interbody fusion no significant difference in range of motion reduction between uni and bilateral fixation. Moreover, unilateral ventricular screw system decrease the stress shielding effect upon the fixed segment. This can reducing the risk of adjacent disc degeneration with sufficient stability from the laboratory study, not only clinical study. It was biomechanically checked. And how about the fusion rate? From the Dr. Xiaolong Shen and Han Liu, also Xiaolong, not only clinical, but Dr. Xiaolong also analyzed radiographically. There is no significant difference between bilateral and unilateral pedicle screw fixation. Comparably similar fusion between both technique and total fusion rate in 6 months is not different significantly. It means the same between two type of instrumentation. How about the clinical? Visual analog scale as the final follow-up. So significant difference. We mean that the patient more prefer unilateral because less pain or visual analog scale. Even though the outcome is the same, but the pain is lesser using unilateral. Yeah, it's obvious because half of the work was done, so half pain happening. How about the claudicatio? From the Oswestry Disability Index, there is no significant difference. That's a good point. Even use half of the instrument, half of the decompression, the OD index are the same. How about the Japan Orthopedic Association score, JOA score? There were no significant difference between unilateral compared to bilateral. The research was conducted by Dr. Huan Liu and also conducted by Dr. Pei Liu. How about the blood loss? There is significant reduction in unilateral fixation. It can be acceptable because half work, half opening, half dissection, everything was half. How about the operative time? Of course, the unilateral pedicle screw associated with shorter operative time. It's common sensely accepted. How about hospital stay, bed occupation? There were no significant difference because the patient usually in day 6 or 7 confidently to be discharged, but not before day 6 or 7, but maybe following the inflammation process. The inflame, the edema, the pain persists about 3 to 5 days. So inflammation process may be the same. How about the cost? Overall, the hospital and instrumentation costs are lower in unilateral fixation. So relatively less clinical complication considering of infection, of injury, and dural injury can be understood because of half of the exposure. And similar rate regarding the hardware complication. So, as the conclusion, unilateral pedicle screw fixation based on all the review that we conduct from the previous report, and also we did the similar procedure not only in the lumbar area but also cervical and thoracic, we can conclude that less invasive instrumentation system can be facilitated by unilateral fixation and similar clinical radiological outcome can provide by unilateral pedicle screw fixation. Of course, with shorter, lower blood loss and less hospital costs comparing to the bilateral one. Maybe that's all. Thank you for listening. Hopefully there are some questions for discussion. And don't forget to stay healthy, keep a positive mind, and always use the mask properly, washing your hand, maintain the distance between others, avoiding the crowd, and less mobility as your limitation for a while until we can survive from the pandemic. Yeah, see you next time. Thank you.